Hello viewers of Neuro-otology channel. Welcome back to episode 2 of our series on vestibular migraine, where we dive deeper into this fascinating topic. In the previous episode, we learned about the official criteria for the recognition and diagnosis of vestibular migraine as presented by the Bárány Society in 2012. But what exactly is vestibular migraine? Can we define it in a simple and clear way? A simple way to define vestibular migraine is that it's a type of migraine that causes vertigo or dizziness, often alongside or instead of a headache. Vestibular migraine is a variant of classical migraine where vertigo and dizziness are the main symptoms, while headache may occur but isn't always necessary. While headache is the dominant symptom in classical migraine, it can also occur in vestibular migraine, but it's less common. Most patients primarily feel vertigo and dizziness during attacks, rather than headache. Classical migraine and its sister, vestibular migraine, share the same origin: complex metabolic and biochemical disturbances happening in different parts of the brain and inner ear. If this disruptive process targets the vestibular system, the main symptoms will be dizziness and vertigo, which defines vestibular migraine. How can we know that vestibular migraine and classical migraine are two variants of the same disease? I observe patients, especially women, who in adolescence and youth period have severe classical migraine, and after a time it subsided, and instead of this, a new symptoms are arising, which is vestibular migraine and which is characterized by vertigo and dizziness, but already without headache. So headaches were replaced by vertigo and dizziness, dependently what age period. This scenario is quite frequent and characteristic. What factors influence whether a woman or man will develop vestibular migraine? Let's explore the key triggers and predispositions. Genetics play a fundamental role, and if a parent has had vestibular migraine, your chances are higher. Genetics play a crucial role in vestibular migraine, but they are not the only factor. Environmental influences, hormonal changes, lifestyle, stress, trauma of the head, and even deficiencies in certain nutrients can also trigger episodes. Usually, it's a combination of several factors working together that trigger vestibular migraine rather than just one. Hormonal changes play a key role in triggering vestibular migraine, which is why it's more common in women. Symptoms often worsen around menstruation and tend to decrease or even disappear during pregnancy when hormonal levels stabilize. Many women find that pregnancy acts as a natural relief from vestibular migraine, and symptoms often diminish or disappear during this period. In addition to genetic predisposition and hormonal changes, stress is a very powerful trigger for migraines. In today's world, stress is widespread and unavoidable. When it becomes intense or overwhelming, it can easily trigger vestibular migraine, making patients particularly vulnerable to its effects. The debilitating nature of vestibular migraine can severely affect quality of life, sometimes leaving patients feeling overwhelmed or hopeless. Of course, environmental changes and lifestyle changes, the way of nutrition, also play a fundamental role in developing vestibular migraine. Lack of certain vitamins like B2 or microelements like magnesium are also powerful triggers that can contribute, not alone but together in a team of other factors, usually to develop vestibular migraine. Head trauma can be a trigger for vestibular migraine, and I've seen in many patients. I remember one man whose symptoms began after a door accidentally dropped on his head. Alright, dear viewers of Neurotology channel, that's all for this episode. Thank you for watching and staying with me. See you in the next one.